Good evening, everybody. Adjust this camera. Hold on here. All right. Okay, so good. There we go. All right, cool. Hey, everyone. Oh, hey, Linda, how are you? Hey, guys, how are you doing? Good evening. Just adjust some equipment here. Back. Hey, Adam, how you doing? All right, guys. Good evening. Hey, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Just adjust my microphone. Good evening. Good evening, Fashion Lips. Dog Training, HV, you're the best. Hey, Bully Brothers, how are you? Hey, everyone. It's Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. It's my Wednesday version. It is October 14th of the What Would Jeff Do webinar. Usually on every Monday and Wednesday from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And it is now 11 p.m. Eastern Standard Time because I'm on the West Coast. The reason why I'm on the West Coast is because I'm on here for a seminar, as most of you know, because I talk about it all the time. And this is my Q&A. And what I do is I do these Q&As on Mondays and Wednesdays because, oh, geez, we get about a dozen, lately about 20 emails a day with folks that are looking for help and guidance with their dogs. And it's really challenging for me to, hey, Connecticut, how are you? It's really challenging for me to answer the questions. Actually, I can't during the week at all. So I'm on three different platforms tonight. I'm on Meerkat. Hey, Meerkat, how are you? WebinarJam. And I'm also on Periscope. So what I want you to do is you can ask me your dog training questions. Periscope, the questions come to me pretty darn quick. So sometimes it's a little bit challenging. Take the lead. Yeah, I am exhausted. I'm exhausted. Yep, definitely exhausted. What are you going to do? Right? So it's okay. It's okay. I'm alive. I'm here. I'm doing okay. Doing great. Let me just check out the lighting. Does that make a difference? Yeah. Better or worse? Huh. All right. So let's get right to the questions. I'm going to be on for an hour tonight, and then that will be it. So dog training questions are now. What you can do is if you're brand new, Periscope, if you're brand new, just type in new. And just to let everybody know, hearts, you can give me lots of hearts by just hitting your screen. Heart, 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 heart. Hey, Camden, how are you? Camden's on Webinar Jam. Just give me lots of hearts. Also, you can share this. And you can, there's a little unisex character in the corner. If you hit that, you can put me on Facebook, put me on Twitter. And if you're watching the replay, you can write, you can do hearts, but you can also swipe and share in that swipe from the left on an iOS and up and down or up on an Android. All right. Yep, things are good. Hey, Nadine, how are you? How are you? Yeah, things are fantastic. I'm out in Battleground, Washington. And the seminar is actually in Battleground, Washington. Good nitwit, dog level is 10. What's a good correction level for the crate whining? You're gonna have to figure it out, nitwit. And I'm not saying that just to be, you know, sarcastic. Experiment with it. You go to 15, go to 20, hit continuous, hit momentary, you know, go fishing. It's called fishing. You go, I mean, you know, if you fish, you throw the line out, you go like this, you bring it back in. Try different things. Try different things with the, with your remotes. So every dog responds a little bit differently. Oh, hey, Cher, how are you? Oh, no problem at all. You're welcome. You're welcome. No problem at all. I do what I do. The first week of e-collar, good. What I want you to do is make sure you pair, nitwit, pair e-collar with food. So you can just do, right now, it's just to make sure you're not just using the remote just for no. Use it for awesome fun stuff. Like all your obedience commands, you just pair with food. God, the lighting is freaking terrible on Periscope. Oh, hey, Adjuster Jeff. Yeah, I unblocked you before. That was a mistake. That was a mistake. Can you correct too high for anxiety or whining if the dog doesn't stop at lower levels? No, sometimes it takes a higher level to actually break through. Remember, when your dog right now is stressed and anxious, so sometimes it'll just take a higher level to break through the nonsense in the brain. So I think a lot of times people are afraid to correct high on the remote because their dog's already fearful, whining, and nervous. But you can't. So just experiment with it a little bit. Place your favorite command. Awesome. Yeah, it's my favorite command too. It's my favorite command too. So a lot of great stuff. Let's get the questions rolling. What's your favorite? E-collar training is what I like the best. So the dog is afraid to lay down. Wait a couple of days on that. Can use a bark collar on the walk. He blows through e-collar corrections with distractions. What level, little Miss Morgie, what level are you doing on the remote? Also, what I want you to do is, awesome, Mama Bear. What I want you to do is wait, and you should be giving that dog information prior to it exploding. So you don't just wait for the explosion. Don't just wait so little as your remote probably goes up to 100, just to give you a heads up. You got a little bit of room there. Don't wait until the dog explodes. Give that dog information way before it explodes, so on a lower level. How do you correct a German Shepherd dog from reacting to bikers? Right now you want to do space, and you want to make sure you've got that dog, give that dog space, do a couple of 180s, do something called crittering, which it's hard to describe right now, but I've got a video on crittering. Don't be afraid to use space, and don't be afraid to work the dog away. So it's been 2 weeks working down, and he just gets, so are you doing down with food? Food and leash pressure? So if your dog's not downing after 2 weeks, that's a lot of work to do. Your dog new to you when other dogs get too near. He growls when other dogs too near. Well, your dog's trying to tell you something. The dog's trying to tell you that your dog is not comfortable. But are these dogs off leash or on leash? Are you off leash? Are you on leash? And what I would do is I keep dogs away from my dogs. So I walk my dog in a proper heel on my left-hand side, and I don't let other dogs approach my dog. So my dog is telling me that I'm not comfortable. But you can correct that too. Camden says, this is Camden on Webinar Jam. Hey, Jeff, you're getting a puppy tomorrow. Watch most of your videos and feeling more or less prepared. Thanks. So Mama Bear, don't let your dog meet dogs on leash. Don't. Old Bird, how you doing? So Shelter said she was good with other dogs. Yeah, but shelters lie. Okay, so shelters lie. Also, shelter dogs probably was off leash. There's no way the shelter most likely assessed the dog properly. That would be a very unique situation if the dog was assessed properly. So, oh, you're welcome, cats. Dogs exploding on walks. What you want to do is all dogs should be food aggression with other dogs. I'll go over that, food aggression. So all dogs should be walking properly next to you. And right now you want to keep your dog in a proper heel. And at the beginning of your dog being reactive to other dogs, you want to utilize space. So utilize space at the beginning. Also make sure you correct the dog sooner. Most people wait till the dog explodes. Everybody waits till the dog explodes. So give the dog information way before. As far as your dog with food aggression on other dogs, what I want you to do is explain how that happens. So is the dog eating out of a bowl and other dogs are around? Because I wouldn't do that. I would always have dogs eat by themselves. They should eat by themselves. You can even feed your dog in the crate if you want to. So if your dog's eating out of a bowl and another, good job, Mama Bear. If your dog's eating out of a bowl and another dog approaches, that's not the best thing. Yep, distractions are always heavy. I don't have any videos on assessing dogs. Because I don't assess a dog, because every dog that comes to me needs training. That dog learned how to do a remote collar heel. Your dog explodes out of the kennel, slam the kennel door right in its face. So what you do is you open, I've got a video on that, open up the door a little bit, and boom. Slam the door in its face. What's your best advice for keeping rude, untrained off-leash dogs away from your leash dog? Kick them. Dog goes behind you, stand in front of your dog, kick the other dog. Also, you can walk with a walking stick, carry pepper spray, bear spray, hornet spray. use your feet, throw something at the dog. Okay. Size 14. Fashion lips. So walking last night, she doesn't leave until her command. She just freaks out afterwards. Have her come out on a leash. So have her come out on a leash. Let's go. And then kennel up. Let's go. Kennel up. Let's go. Kennel up. We got a professional trainer to help with the walk. So it's all energy. So it's all energy stuff. You know, so it's all energy stuff. That's what you've got to do. Introducing the dog to other dogs should always be off leash. And you also have to know the energy of the other dog. So I would never introduce my dog to a strange dog. So I only introduce my dog in a structured socialization setting, which is on my property or where I've got 100% control over every single dog. So I would never let a owner with a dog that I don't know meet my dog, especially on leash, because dogs on leashes can't properly meet. Also, you don't know anything about that dog, and the other dog could be, RV dog training, you're gonna learn a lot about energy. Absolutely, most of RV dog training, most of what I do is about energy. Okay, so if you're in the friend's yard, what I would do is I would first go for a walk and see how they do. And then also you can have them make sure that other dog is the dog friendly or not? Is the other dog friendly? And then you can have them dragging leashes, but don't let them get around in a high play. Keep the energy low. So I would start by going, Mama Bear, start by going on a structured walk and then do calming exercises in the house. Take them outside, let the leash drag and see how they do. But don't let them go into high drive play right away. Don't let them go into high drive play right away. All right, good. So friendly, if the dog has got too much energy, dogs misinterpret that. So what I would do then is I would let the leashes drag and just see how they do. Jilly, I would put that dog in a kennel. You can also close the door on it, but I'm a big fan of not keeping dogs in rooms. Just put them in kennels. Just put them in a kennel. Fashion Lip says, so walking last night, dog on walk, crazy dog on leash coming towards my dog, barks and lunges, have prong and remote. I would just move away. So if you got a crazy dog, Fashion Lips, coming towards you, I get out of the way, way out of the way. How to correct a dog who gets aggressive while correcting on the prong. What I would do with a dog, I missed that question. But crazy dogs I move away from. There was a question that I just missed. It was on Periscope. It was about a crate, breaking out of the crate. How to correct a dog who turns aggressive after being corrected. Okay, so what it is there's a bunch of different things. So once the dog is aggressive, you miss the opportunity. So you want to get that information to the dog way before. So what you want to do is you want to look for small moments of the dog getting excited, and you want to give the information to that dog then. But once that dog explodes, chances are that energy has got to go somewhere. A lot of times it goes up the leash. So you've got to be super, super careful about that. Okay. So what I would do is I would do a combination of information and space at the beginning. So information and space, moving. You can move a little bit away, you can move a little bit backwards. I don't want you running for the hills, but I want you to be able to let that dog give you information. Also, train the dog remote collar healing. Do remote collar healing for that dog. So do remote collar healing for that dog. So once your dog masters the remote collar heal, you can really control its energy so much better. It's so much easier to control that dog's energy with remote collar healing. Makes it hard because it's not just about, do I have a video of that moment? Yoda, remote coward healing. I don't have any videos on that. I'll make one. We're going to do it at the seminar this weekend. We're doing it at the seminar this weekend. So I'll try to capture that on film. I'll try to capture Sean doing some remote coward healing. I'll put it up. I'll do my best to put it up. So your dog playing, you're playing so she's easily aroused and play leading to aggression. So that's more of, that's energy issue. So if she goes from play to aggression, that's, you got to be really careful about, is that really play? And also define aggression, or is it just the improper use of her mouth or lack of impulse control? It's a remote coward electric. It's actually not electric shock at all. There's no shocking or zapping at all. So it is a stim. Most remote collars do have a vibration. I do not use the vibration mode. So it's a stim. I don't like to use the word shock because that implies, like if I stuck my finger in an outlet, that's a shock. So it's stim, like a TENS unit, okay? It's a TENS unit, which is sort of, which is a transepidural neurological stimulator. It's the same thing, it's a muscle contractor. So there's no shocking or zapping because that actually implies that you're trying to harm the dog. You also can't regulate a shock. So remote collar training is much, much different than remote collars that were 10 years ago, 20 years ago, 30 years ago, where they didn't have as many variable levels. So the goal is to dial in right at the level that the dog is, you know, believes you. Correcting a dog when she starts focusing hard on another dog. Remote collars always do. Remote collar healing is the best. So getting a dog to walk on a remote collar is going to be probably everybody's best option. But what you don't do is you don't want to just, you're not going to just wait till the dog explodes. You want to give that dog information as soon as it gets aroused. Sometimes it is at a higher setting too, because the dog won't believe you at anything else. So if you've got a dog that's a practiced leash exploder, the dog's not going to believe you when you're soft with the dog, which a lot of owners might struggle with. But the goal is to get the dog to believe that you have control over the situation, which doesn't happen a lot, So if you've got a really leash reactive dog, it can be really, really challenging, really challenging. So I've got a bunch of videos on, I probably can do a better job on that. What's the best remote collar? I like e-collar technologies. Go to e-collar.com. And you can also go to my website. Ozzy, just to let you know, a lot of times, first of all, I love you, buddy, and I love your comments. When you make a comment on my my Facebook page and you write in all caps, it actually automatically hides. It hides the comments. So sometimes I don't even see them. You've been calling her here and putting in heel. So if your dog's on a walk, it should be next to you. It should be next to you anyway. So is the dog off leash, Becca? Is the dog off leash? Because if your dog's dog reactive, you probably shouldn't have it off leash until you master on leash. You master on leash. I missed one question too. Fashion lips, after you give signals before exploding, you give correction and you have to give a big correction. You don't necessarily, just keep walking. Keep walking. It's hard to talk about without demonstrating how to, there's so many variables in dogs exploding. It can be really, really challenging. It can be really challenging. Fashion lips. So I'm going to have to do demos. I'm going to have to do a Periscope demo, and it might have to wait until I'm back in Rhode Island, or I can maybe do it at the seminar. Oh, it was in the mountains off leash. She didn't like the other female dog. So what I would do is I would call. You want to, so if you're doing out, if you're a backpacker or a hiker, what you want to do is you want to constantly be calling your dog back to you. Oh, about a dog getting afraid while laying down. I would never allow an unknown dog to approach my dog in a down. So I would never allow that. I would advocate more for my dog. So I would never allow that unless my dog was bomb-proof, but not too many dogs are bomb-proof. You know, I've got a few dogs that are bomb-proof, but I frankly don't trust other dogs. So, but if you're out in the mountains, always call your dog back to you. So call your dog back. So don't wait until another dog approaches. You know, every 5 minutes, you should be calling your dog back on a recall. And then you can move off the path a little bit if you want to. Give your dog space. Give your dog space, yeah. And without content, it's, if you get a leash reactive dog, there are so many variables. There are so many variables. See, that's the issue with that. It's not as cut and dry as like sit down, place, barking, whining, fence fighting, counter surfing, getting in the trash. Leash reactivity's got so many variables, and it's not just a big, huge bam. There's so many variables. There's so many variables to it. Oh. So your foster dog is laying down. My dog goes smelling him and the foster goes after him. So what I would do is this. I would keep your dog on a leash. Keep your dog on a muzzle. So muzzle the foster dog. So muzzle the foster dog. And what you can do is if you muzzle the foster dog and just correct it for doing it, but also your foster dog is letting you know it doesn't like that. So what I would do is I would get both of them together moving, getting them together moving, even walking around, keep the foster dog on a leash. Yeah, because there's movement dog training HV. There's movement. So movement is key. So what I would do is when you're walking your foster dog, let the other dog go up and sniff it. But control the head of the foster dog. I would muzzle up your foster dog, though. What you also can do is you can, next time the dog does that, you can give it a pretty good correction. You know, we do that all the time. Use a dressage whip. Again, there's a lot of variables. I have to read the energy. A lot of variables to that. So Camden Jenny says, obedience training versus behavior modification. Do you pair behavior modification with no, for example? So jumping on guests gets a pretty high consequence, and there's no no or off. It's just a consequence. So someone asked me on Webinar Jam about dogs jumping on guests. So what I would do is this, is prong collar on the dog, leash on the dog, role play it. Then what I would do is you give the dog a pretty firm leash correction for that. You can also use a remote collar. Personally, what I would want to do is I wouldn't want to wait till a guest came over. I would want to role play that. Also, I don't want your dog around approaching guests either. Put the dog in place for now. Put the dog in place. The dogs can escalate with a high level correction. All depends on your timing. There's so many variables on that. I don't know if Sean and I would have time to make a video. It's really, really challenging to do because of our schedule. And I don't know if I can film T3. So. All right, if you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I'm a dog trainer based in Providence, Rhode Island. And you can go to my website, solidcaninetraining.com. The dog is jazzed right out of the gate, but he's chill in the house. Yep, so keep the dog calm. Keep the dog calm in when you first go outside. So you got to work on your energy stuff. I personally don't let my dogs wander around my house, but I don't have traditional house dogs. Fashion Loop says, do you know when you will have place YouTube? I've got place YouTube videos now. No problem, Ish Coast. It could be my connection too. It could be my connection. I'm in a hotel. I set up a separate MiFi just for Periscope. Flea and Tick, I use Advantix. How long do you keep them in place? Depends what I'm doing, as long as I need them to be in place. But my dogs are outside a lot too. So my dogs are at work or they're outside. At night, they come up into my office. Two of them do. But I've got a lot of outside dogs. They go into a kennel at night. I've got a kennel room. So, hey, everybody on Periscope, Webinar Jam, and everybody on Meerkat, how are you? Madly in love with you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. You've been, what food for puppies? So I don't. Usually puppies, I'll use the owner's food, whatever they did, but I feed Canada. You can also feed raw. So I'm not the nutrition guy or the medical guy, but you can do Canada would be the kibble that I would feed would be Canada. Yeah, Ozzy, two females are rough. You're going to need professional help for that. I wouldn't even begin to attempt to tell you about how to rehab two female fighting dogs on Periscope. I think that would be a little bit unethical for me. We do it all the time. It's not something for just regular. That would be a Skype visit. I don't want to just casually just give you answer, casually do it. I don't want to do that. That wouldn't be good. That wouldn't be good. So hearts are going up. If you like the content, you give me lots of hearts. You also can share this. You also can share on this on Facebook and Twitter. There's a little character in the bottom right corner. If you hit that, you can share this on your Facebook. You can share this on Twitter. If you're watching the replay, you can swipe and share. Swipe left, right for iOS, up and up from down to up for Android, and you can share this as well. And make sure you follow me. Make sure you follow me. Follow me on Twitter. Follow me on all my social media, Facebook. And I do these. I do daily Periscopes, and then Monday and Wednesday I do these Q&As. Normally I'm on at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, but all this week and all next week. Next week I'm in Hawaii. I'm doing a seminar, so I'll be doing it at the same time. Probably I might be able to adjust the timing there. Yeah, so Ozzy, I know they used to be good together, but if they're feeding, you know, there's probably little messages. Ozzy, that's probably going to be, a Skype visit. Bring the RV to San Francisco. What you want to do, Cato, is you want to email my assistant, Lauren at Solid Canine Training, L-A-U-R-E-N, and you can talk to her about. Yeah, fear, you know. Remote collar is not, just keep in mind guys, remote collar is not just for blasting a dog. Remote collar is for really low level communication as well. Yeah. So if you got an excited dog, teach it calming skills. You want to teach it calming stuff. A lot of times people just think that the dog needs more exercise. The dog actually also needs to learn how to chill out. The dog has to learn how to chill out too. New York City, nope. If you've got, Ozzy, if you're in New York City, you come up to my training center in Providence, Rhode Island. Come up to my training center in Providence, Rhode Island. Okay, that's where you're better off coming up to. You could also, I've got a seminar. Why don't you look into my, so Ozzy, rvdogtrainer.com, rvdogtrainer.com. I've got a seminar coming up in our Providence that you should bring your dogs to. I don't know. I'm not an expert on nutrition. The hardest part is not teaching the dogs. In many cases, I had a high energy dog when he shows up. Yeah. Yeah. Teaching dogs calming skills is you got to rest the mind of the dog. See, we don't tire dogs out to train them. Yep. Yep. You can stay in place for 2 hours. Yeah. We don't tire dogs out. We just slow their mind down. How do you train the dog to relax in the crate? What you do is you can work on duration work out of the crate. You also, what I would do is this. You put the dog in the crate, put the dog into a down and reinforce down. Reinforce down in the crate. You can also get the dog to do it with the door open. You can also do it with the door open as well. All right. Jeff in California on Webinar Jam says, hi, Jeff. E-collar, yep, e-collar, yeah. We e-collar train every dog. Hi, Jeff. Issue with my personal dog today. Came around a blind corner, came within 10 feet of a guy walking a small dog. Hit e-collar set as usual, corrective level, and hit as I moved, called me away to create distance. But the moment we turned, he exploded, lunging, freaking out, growling, total meltdown. So Jeff, put a dominant dog collar on your dog, and your timing was just off. Your timing was just off. Yep, you can find a small dog. Find a small dog. Reinforce down in the continuum with treats. Now, there's no reason that we don't use treats at all. We would use their daily food. Reinforce it is once the dog knows down, you just can use the remote, reinforce it. Gets up, you just say no, down, low level stim on continuous, the dog downs, you release the body and you say good. Yep, We do it all the time. Because if you just keep, if you feed the dog treats, you're trying to calm the dog down. It's going to get the dog ramped up. It's going to get the dog ramped up. So we're trying to get the dog to be calm, not the dog ramped up. Historically, when you give the dog treats, it gets excited. But we use food at the beginning for remote collar training. But for the now, to reinforce it, you would just keep doing the dog in a down. So once you teach that dog how to do remote collar down, you can teach it how to do remote collar down, even if you're not in front of the dog. You have to do it from another room. Yeah, do it from another room. Yeah, about giving, you know, giving food while down, and now he elevates a lot. There you go. That's it. It's pretty Pavlovian, right? So I know. It's the anticipation of food. So working on a dog holding place command when the person leaves the room, there's a couple of different ways, Jen. What you can do is you can do it 1 second at a time. 1 second at a time. So you turn the corner. You first turn your dog, turn your back to the dog, and the dog, see what the dog does. Leave the room for a second, leave the room for 2 seconds, 3 seconds. Also put that dog in a tie out, so, or a tie back, so the dog can break place, but he can't come running to you. And then first you want to teach that dog how to do a remote collar place, and remote collar down. And then once you reach that level, you reinforce the down in place from out of the room with a tie back. But you want to do that in very slow increments, very slow increments. So we did it. I did it today. So I did it today with a dog in a crate that doesn't even know it. Hey, Nellie, how are you? So there's a dog today that was in a crate standing up, and we just used the remote. How would you fix resource guarding between dogs at home, Jeff? What are they guarding, Claudia? What are they guarding? What are they guarding? Thanks everybody for restreaming it, for favoring it, for liking it a lot. Everybody in Periscope, hey, it's Jeff with Solid Canine Training. If you're just tuning in, your dogs are doing so much better since we stopped. Yeah, of course. Yeah, that's good. They're kibble, so do they eat next to other audio? Are they eating next to each other? What you can do is you can do something called dog is trained off leash. Why risk around others when they will come after my dog? Kibble and toys. So kibble and toys, kibble should be fed. What you can do is you can do a couple of, feed them now. Just feed them separately. Most dogs eat within a minute, sometimes two to five minutes. You can feed them separately. That's what I would do. You can feed them separately. So what I would do is, though, is you can take all their kibble, throw it all over the ground, and they've got to forage for it. So what, thank you, Kato. Love you. You're the best, too. Love you, hon. What you can do is you could, you'll see videos. We've got videos on Facebook, and we've got videos on YouTube, I believe, of tweet. You'll see us taking a bunch of food, throwing it on the ground. The dogs have to forage for it. At the beginning, keep them on leashes with two separate handlers ready to move them away if they aggress. So what you can do is that's just how they eat their food. You can also start feeding them separately. But if you do a food foraging technique, I wouldn't let dogs, all my personal dogs eating kennels. I have no problem at all. I'm not out to prove anything. So just feed them in kennels. There's no reason why you can't just throw them in a crate and feed them. You're welcome. I'm not sure if that Funkel Cert, I'm not sure which video that was. I get a lot of videos sent to me. I'm not sure which one. Yeah, Claudia, don't let anybody tell you that's not training. So if somebody says to you, oh, geez, you should be able to feed them out of their crates, you know what? Just make your life easier, right? Just make your life easier. I mean, how long does it take to – my dogs eat twice a day. It takes them anywhere from 1 minute to 3 minutes to eat. That's 2 to 6 minutes a day out of a 24-hour a day. Feed the freaking dogs in the crate. Right now, while I'm on the road, my 8 and 10-year-olds are taking care of a bunch of five of my dogs. Guess what? Kennel up. They give them put the carabiner on it. They eat, open the door, take the food bowl out, put it on top of their kennel. growls. And you know what? Then they let them outside. How easy is that? How easy is that? Sometimes I've got 10 dogs. Sometimes my kids feed all my dogs. It's so much easier. You know? Yeah, good for you, Ozzy. Yeah, look at Ozzy. He's got 5 dogs. Yep. Yep. It's so much easier. You know, it's so much easier. Everybody, you know, you'll always see a photo or a video online of like all these dogs eating like bowls next to them. Yeah, that's great. That's wonderful. I could do it too. And a lot of owners can do it too. But in my world, I want to make things easier. That's it. And but some dog trainers will try to shame you on that. Some dog trainers will tell you, well, your dogs really aren't well behavior trained. So fine. So my dogs suck. Guess what? It's easier for me. And I'm sorry, but my 8 and 10 year old and Angelo is 3. Has anybody ever seen a video of Angelo feeding my dogs? There's a video on YouTube of Angelo when he was 2 years old feeding 800 pounds of dogs. Okay? Large German Shepherds, pitties. Why? He feeds them in their kennels. He was 2 years old. Who cares? Like, get over it. People have got to get over it. Just like, kennel up, feed, 5 minutes, boom, you're done. That's it. It's simple. Now go play. Yep, you can use a remote collar. Yeah, resource guarding bones, we would have a high level. Well, your dog snaps at dogs at the park. It might not be obvious to you, but it's obvious to the dog. So it's obvious to the dog. The dog probably doesn't like the pressure. But if you're talking, are you talking about a dog park or just like at the park? Because I don't recommend dog parks. Building up confidence, if you don't have agility equipment, just first of all, you can make your dog go up onto like, get a step stool, get a Bosu ball. Yeah, can we fix that with remote collar? All depends, I need context. Yep, lots of hearts for Angelo. Angelo is the coolest dude in the world. Yep, we've got 6 daughters and then Angelo, he's our first son. He's 3 now. Yep, Ozzy, you got the right idea, buddy. You got the right idea. So I don't want you just correcting your dog. Treadmill helps confidence. Chelsea, thank you, great idea. Treadmill, training in general helps confidence. Playing sound effects while you're working your dog, playing sound effects when your dog's in place or duration. You can also go to a playground when it's closed where there's no kids. You can do that. If you can find fire escapes, the ones that are with steps that the dogs can't see, the dogs can see through, that builds confidence. Put the dogs on different surfaces that are a little bit movement, that builds confidence. Train the dog some tricks. Going in and out of your legs and stuff. I don't do that stuff, but you could. There's a lot of ways to build confidence. So if you're just tuning in, my name is Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Go to solidcaninetraining.com. There's a little guy in the corner. You can hit that little guy. It's a unisex character. Hit that little guy, and then you can share this on Facebook, share this on Twitter. Yep, skateboard parks, yep. And if you're wondering what all the hearts are, those are people that are tapping their screens. They're going tap, 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 tap. They're tapping their screens. Hey, Meerkat, how are you guys? So tonight I'm on Meerkat, Periscope, and then on WebinarJam. So I'm on 3 different platforms. You corrected Lola yesterday in the kitchen. Now on a level 6, she runs to me like it was a 50. Yep. Remember, the levels are just numbers. They're just reference points. They're just reference points. So, your dog, if you're with men, do we just have men hand feed the dog? That's one way to do it, but you could also make sure that your dog just exists. So let's try to do just existence first. So try to do existence. But there's a couple of protocols you can do with men. It takes, there's a counter conditioning food advocacy protocol that I do. It's also on my website. I mean, on my YouTube channel. And if you ever see a dog in a tie back and with my kids on sitting down in front of a dog, there's usually 3 kids. That's a counter conditioning food protocol. I think on my behavior modification section, you'll see it. Do you ever work with multiple clients' dogs and homes together? So I don't do at-home visits anymore. Everything is done at the training center. Everything is done at the training center. So lower your levels. Lower your levels, Becca. Just lower your levels. Now she's just more sensitive. So lower your, the working level might be one or two now. Levels fluctuate. Stacy, how long to hold a dog on a treadmill if they will not walk on it at one time to teach? It depends on what the dog is doing. If the dog is putting on the brakes, if the dog is putting on the brakes, you know what? I got a treadmill video I can do. I mean, I got treadmill videos up there now. But if the dog is putting on the brakes, I've got a very specific protocol on how I do treadmill training. So, but if the dog is putting on the brakes, what I would do is brakes. So I would just pull the dog off and try to do it again. So you want to get, you want to start at 1 mile per hour. You want to get 1 foot at a time, 1 foot at a time. So try to do gentle pops, pop, 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 pop. Okay, try to do that. Try to get those dogs' legs to be moving. Anything to get the dog's legs to be moving. So you can use a lot of like, let's go, come on, let's go. You're welcome. Good night. Love you. A little slow tonight, huh? Working level with my German Shepherd dog is 7 dogs walk by him, dial up to 25 to get his attention. I don't know. I would do focus work too. Do focus work. Do some food focus protocols. Food focus protocols with a remote. So I would do that. 25 might not get his attention. Every dog is a little bit different when it comes to levels. 25 might be meaningless. 25 might blow his mind. You're welcome, New 04. You're welcome. Excuse me. You live by the elevated trains and one of your dogs is terrified of it. What's the best way to get her through? What I would do is this. I would get I would get a soundtrack of the trains, and I would I would feed your dog around the soundtrack. Claudia, yeah, I would absolutely not allow your dog to do that behavior. I would absolutely not let your dog do that behavior. Because if your dog did that to me, it wouldn't end well. So she puts on the brakes for the treadmill or for, oh, when you're walking, you're out walking your dog. Yeah, I would get that dog desensitized to the train noise. Yeah. I would get that dog. So I would play soundtracks of trains during mealtime and training. Work that dog through. Work it through. So I would walk that dog by itself and do a lot of one-on-one training to get that dog over it. So you can do is you can take a food bowl out, outside by the end frames. And eventually the dog will eat. If it's too nervous to eat, which it might be, it'll eventually will eat. You bring it back in, try it for dinner. Yeah, there is, Claudia, that's so specific. What I would do with your dog would have to be in a structured socialization setting at my training center. So if a dog ran up to another dog and got stiff, believe it or not, we would use your dressage whip, a 5-foot tall dressage whip with a 12-inch drop. If your dog did that, we would just give it a double tap on the butt, tap, tap. What that do is that would de-escalate the dog's energy, and the dog would probably move away. It would move away. So, and we keep your dog on a leash at the beginning to make sure we can pull it away as well. That's totally unacceptable behavior. We call that bad greeting. Your dog could also get into a fight. Trust building exercises, do tons of training. Food focus protocols, I've got that on my website. I've got that on my Facebook page. Yeah, so Claudia, if you've seen the dressage whips, you know what I'm talking about. Yep, just like in Ottawa. Yep. You can find a whip like that. You can go to any horse tack shop. Any horse tack shop is fine. Any horse tack shop is fine. So you can do that. can get it from, we have Tractor Supply by us. I'm not sure what other people have by them. Yeah, I'm exhausted. Don't worry, show's almost over. I'll be okay. I'll be okay. Don't worry about me. You're welcome, Fashion Lips. You're welcome. I'm fine. Do I do any training with tennis balls? No, but you could. You could. You can use the tennis ball as the reward. But don't do the actual tennis balls, because the stuff's bad for their teeth. The glue is bad for their teeth. So I have a video on e-collar smart dogs. What does that mean? What's e-collar smart mean? I don't know. Yeah, you can use whatever motivates the dog, whatever motivates. The great thing about food is you deliver like 20 pieces of kibble, one at a time, really quick, where the dog takes twice longer. Yeah, tennis balls definitely wear down the dog's teeth. Same with me. I learned my lesson from Uma. She chews on tennis balls. But chocolate makes a good ball. Your dog stayed focused on you for 1 hour. It'd be nice if your dog could relax. I don't know if females are inherently harder to train. I don't know. I don't know about that. I mean, females fighting are usually the worst. Two females fighting, though, are pretty nasty. The worst fights I've ever seen have been females. They'll fight to the death. Not to say a male dog won't, but two females, they wake up and they're ready to fight. Ready to fight. They don't forget. Jeff in California says, thanks as always, man, getting another dog adopted out. Oh, good for you. Good for you, buddy. Good. No, girl was, I got girl at 8 months old, and I got her from a potential client. So I wouldn't train his dog because of his schedule. I didn't like the amount of time the dog was going to be home. So I told him he's better off spending his money on a doggy daycare than on training. And so a week later, he called me up and he asked me if I wanted her. So I got her at about 8 months old. So I've had her now for about 3 years, maybe now, 3 years. Yep. Yeah, Ozzy knows. He's got two female dogs that fight. They'll fight to the death. It's hard. It's hard. Could aggressive greetings be corrected with e-collar? They could be, but what's an aggressive greeting? And I'd probably want to stop it before that. And also muzzles would be involved. Oh, great. Okay, am I going to see Austin again? I'm going to be in Austin coming up. I don't know the dates. Something November 14th, but I'm not sure. I'm traveling a lot in the next 4 months. And then we're finalizing Australia. Oh, good. You'll be there. Cool. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Curling of the lip. What I would do is I would stop that. I would stop that. But new 04, there's so many variables to that. Like, what are you doing? Is the dog on a leash? Is your dog walking up to a dog? Is the dog walking up to another one? Any suggestions on how to calm down a male dog when there's a female in heat? Keep them away from each other. Everything mastiff. I don't deal with too many females in heat. But I mean, that's you might be really, 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 really going against. I don't throw genetics out there that much, but we're talking about some pretty damn primal shit going on, right? Dogs kill over a dog in heat. Going near San Francisco anytime? Nope. Oh, across the street? God, that's a rough one. So if there's someone's got a female in heat, they shouldn't be out in public. They shouldn't be out in public. When they only do things when they, oh, so if they only do things when the collar is on, your dog is collar smart. So what I want you to do is they should wake up in the morning, put their equipment on, and you take their equipment off at night. So that's what you mean. Yeah. I mean, I would, you know, someone's got a female dog in heat, they shouldn't be taking their dog out in public. Yeah. Be really super careful. If the dog has it on for 12 hours, I mean, are you prompting everything, Stacey, or have you gone to correction mode? And how long have you been working on it? First of all, how long have you been working your dog on a remote? Your puppy sits when I say let's go. How old's the puppy? First of all, how old's your puppy? And is your dog on a leash too? Is your dog on a leash? Good toys for dogs. I mean, my dogs really don't have a lot of toys. They just like do stuff, but we, you know, they do chuck it. They do frisbee. 3 months old. So you're looking at a 12-week-old. So 12-week-old dog, flow is they're going through some fear stages right now. So what I would do is this, I would use the daily kibble, not treats. I would use daily kibble. And what I would do is I would work the dog. There's something called come sit break or recall sit break. What I want you to do is go to my YouTube channel and watch that video. And I want you to do that. Okay. So what you want to do is you'll be break. And when you do break, you actually get the dog to move. So use the food for movement. And if you want to use a little bit of leash pressure, you can. So food and leash pressure. So what I want you to do is only feed your dog with training. So feed your dog its daily kibble through training exercises, and I think that will really dramatically help you. But remember, 12 weeks old, there's a lot of dogs that are like, I'm afraid of things. So do a lot of confidence building exercises, M flow. Make sure what you're doing now is I want you to download tons of different soundtrack music, not music, of sounds of like doorbells and cars and trucks and fire engines and police cars and thunderstorms and fireworks, and play them really low while you're doing your training, but do it all with food. Build that dog's confidence up, and then find something fun to do. Include food into like training into sort of like a game. Try to like right now, you should make it a lot of fun, and then eventually you'll hold your dog more accountable. Try that. All right. So 2 months, if your dog, 2 months is not long enough. 2 months isn't long enough. So work your dog hard for a year on a remote. Good job. M flow. Good job. M flow, this is your first time here, right? Training treats for rough cats was a hard one. People use sometimes dried liver. Sometimes they use dried liver. Sometimes you also dehydrate the food. You can dehydrate the food and then break it apart. Oh, cool. So Wednesdays I do a Q&A webinar, but I Periscope every day though. I Periscope every day, just talking in the morning, talking. So, oh, 2 to 8 months? No, that's not too young. No, not at all. We start dogs on prong at 12 to 14 weeks old. Yeah, 8 months, no. Eight months, absolutely not. Oh, good, Claudia. Food counter conditioning for cats into pregnancy would be, I wouldn't do food for that. I would just correct the dog with the remote. Tell the dog to mind his own business. So there's some things that were like, what are you, nuts? E-collar close to the ears, or if you're going on walks, the prong collar's up high. If you're working the dog in the house, just have the remote collar up high. Yep. Thanks, everybody. They can share this. There's a little character in the corner, a little unicef character. Click on that. You can share this to Facebook, share this to Twitter. CrossFit, Mike, I actually did, I never finished my thought. Yeah, I do that a lot. I'm in Maui this time. CrossFit Mike, get your butt over to Maui. Come on. Get your butt over to Maui. Bring the kids. I guess I got a lot of interest from, ever since I announced the Maui seminar, I get everybody from Oahu wants me. But it's the seminar's already done. It's a done deal. So if you want me on Oahu, we have to find a venue. Let's find a venue to do it on. Do it at, I should say. Make sure you follow me and get alerts. To make sure you don't. Thanks, guys. Thanks. I'll be here tomorrow. I got to come up with a morning. I never know my morning. Oh, good. Yeah. You saw the video about share. Yeah. Yep. People don't quite understand balance trainers get hate mail. One of my colleagues got 846 pieces of hate mail in one day. 846. She was threatened to be raped and killed. She was, business was threatened. It was terrible. With or without a dog in Maui, you can dog. You just have to get a working spot. I'm not a big fan of dog parks in general. Yep, it is crazy dog training HV. Yeah, Cher's video was very helpful. Yep, she had a lot of hate mail on that too. Future goals, have you and Linda come to Miami in my future rants? Sure. But Linda doesn't do the RV seminar. She doesn't do any of the teaching, but we'll be down in Florida though, Mishkos, in January and February. Yeah, Canine Angel, some of this stuff was reported, but she just reports, bans, and deletes. But some of the death threats were reported. Maui with a dog. You can come to Maui with a dog. What you've got to do is go to rvdogtrainer.com, CrossFit Mike, rvdogtrainer.com, and you can get an online ticket. Everything's done online. Pay online, do everything online. Yeah, some of it was the best thing to do though is just to ban and delete those people. They can't see you. Yep, happens all the time. For people that say they're pure positive, for people that are say pure positive, it's the really mean people, most of them. Yep. Your girlfriend was yelled at today because we were crate training our puppy. Yep. A lot of crazy people out there. I wish people would just mind their own business. Yep. I've gotten some pretty nasty threats. My life has been threatened too. Many a time. Yeah, without the dog, yep, you'll learn a lot still. You'll learn a lot. Very unprofessional. It's criminal, actually, but yes. For a fellow dog trainer to be making to attack personally another dog trainer, that's beyond unprofessional. That's like really, it's like, wow, they must not have a lot of business. Yeah. Why do some dogs not like children? It could be just lack of socialization. You know what I mean? And also kids move different. Kids can be louder. Kids put a lot of pressure on dogs. It could be a bad experience, but we usually see it's just lack of socialization. We just see it's lack of socialization. That's the biggest thing we see with children. All right, guys, it's time to go. No, I don't know of anybody. I don't know of anybody CrossFit, Mike. You're on your own. Come on, Mike. You're in the military. You're a military guy. You figured out, right? All right. May I love you guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. One last round of hearts. Heart, if you like this. And then you can also make sure you share this. All right. Good night, everybody. Good night. Good night. I really appreciate all you guys. Hey, Felix, take care. Oh, yep. Sweden, it's morning time. You're welcome, Angel. Much love to all of you. I will. I will. Mishkos, you're a Facebook fan of hers. You can send her love, too. Good night, everybody. I'm madly in love with you guys. You guys are very special in my life. I want you to know that I appreciate everything. Got a couple hours of work to do still, and then I'll see everybody in the morning. So, all right, don't worry. I'm getting sleep. All right, good. Mishkos, you and Linda should be having an online relationship by now. Come on, step it up, would you? Okay, Linda's a really cool person. Really cool. She's super cool, right? So I think your Facebook friends were there. I'm pretty sure you are. All right, guys. So reach out. Mishkos, reach out to her. Right? Reach out to her. Don't be afraid. She's a super cool chick. Okay? She's a super cool chick. If you're friends with her, that's rare because she rarely has a friend. And she, all my fans, like, she doesn't friend. She's not friends with most dog trainers at all. All right? Because we have to be really super careful. We've got to protect her as well. Okay? Protect her. It's not a jealousy thing. It's just a lot of crazy things going on out there. Okay, a lot of crazy things. All right. Yeah, I'm in love with you guys.